What's the point of God creating a world which is soon going to be destroyed?
Okay, it's a very blunt question fired at every world religion and every system of thought. He says, why did God bother to create? Why? What was missing? What did this chap miss that he needed to create? So he gives all kinds of excuses, you know. I mean, in the Vedas, they said excuses that he was feeling lonely by himself. So he said, let's create, let's be many. But you know, that's still not a good answer. Think about it. It's not a good answer because that means something was lacking. I mean, he feels lonely. God feeling lonely, this is terrible. It's like human beings. It's like us with desires and lonely. This is not a good answer. The good answer, why this creation? And I'll give you two answers. The one that Sri Ramakrishna gave, he said, look, why are you asking me? Go and ask God. I didn't create. And when God created, he didn't put me in the committee. So I don't know why he created. So I have no clue. You go and ask him. Now this is the way to push away the question. I'm not going to answer. You go and ask God. That's understandable. It's an honest answer saying, ask God. It's not meant for me. I was not in the committee when the creation process started. So he said, okay, Mr. Lakhani, I'll tell you why I'm creating. So I don't know. Ask God. This is a simple answer. The real answer is this in the Hindu religion. Philosophical answer. Very honest answer. This comes from Swami Vivekananda. He said, to the blunt question of why this creation, there's a blunt answer. And the blunt answer is really the same as Ramakrishna gave, but slightly more rough. He says, I don't know. You say, there's an answer? Yes. There is a disjoint here between this perfect, pristine Brahman and the world that we see. There's a disjoint. How can this thing that's ever perfect become imperfect like this, or scattered like this, through all these living things and all the harshness? How can this be? How do you reconcile? And it always remains disjoint. That's why Swami Vivekananda said it will remain unanswerable. Unanswerable. But you see, that is still not good enough for us. We must need a way of dealing with it. How do you deal with it? How do you try and relate to it? Two ways you relate to it. And the two words Hinduism throws out to explain why creation. It doesn't really give the answer. It says, basically says, I don't know, but it tries to say, let's deal with it. How do we live with this creation rather than answer the question? It's with two words. The words are Leela and Maya. The word Leela says it is God alone who's just messing about, Leela playing. It is God alone who has become the animals who are eating each other, tearing each other apart. It is God alone who has become you and me. It's God alone who is creating and messing about in all the living forms. God alone taking on all these forms. It is just a play. You say play, it's a harsh play. The animal carrying each other, that woman lost her son and she's crying. There's a play, you think? There's Leela? Yes, on one side God is crying, on the other side he's laughing. The same God playing, taking on all the roles. In one place he's crying, in one place he's laughing. So you see this in the Bhagavad Gita. The same God, the idea of the same God. Not as a super being, but in a way living through all these human beings. You see, this idea of Virat Swarup is that. The idea of God in all these forms. This is one answer called Leela. It doesn't say the why creation, it simply says how to deal with creation. The second answer that comes from Advaita Vedanta is the idea of Maya. This is a frightening answer, in a way unusual. It says there is no creation. So there's no creation. What is all this then? There's just an appearance. Appearance. You see, when we explain Brahman, remember we said Brahman is underpinning, but it appears as the universe. We use the word appears. We didn't say Brahman becomes the universe. Because then all the problems of the universe become the problem of Brahman, because that is part and parcel of Brahman. We see it appears, means it is not really that, it appears. So the second answer is, there is no universe, there is no creation. You say, but this in front of me, oh, that's just an appearance. But that's true. You say, but the question is so pointed, that's true in appearance. You say, but this is like, you're putting me off. But the thing is, and a person who is critical of religion says, this is a, you know, cop-out. You're running away from answering the question. And when he does this, Sangha says, yes, that's why I told you there is no answer. See? We're honest. Hinduism is honest. It won't say, oh, God is saying that, okay, I create you so you can love me more. Why should he do that? He can click his finger, you love him anyway. You don't need to create and go through this process. So it doesn't make sense. You mustn't give a waffle. The answer is blunt and don't know. And you still push me and say, okay, I'll give you two words to play with. Leela and Maya. Just play with, that's all I can say. There's not an answer really. It's to explain away this disjoint.